Now, few, if any, are immune to the impact of the bad economy, and as of today, that includes the state's biggest private employer. Johns Hopkins announced a number of steps to save money. Our lead investigative reporter, Jane Miller, is live in the newsroom. She has details on that story for us. Jane?
Ron, education and health care have held up best as the economy has shed productivity and jobs. But the steps announced by Johns Hopkins today are a clear indication this recession spares no one.
Faced with the potential of $100 million less in revenues over the next 2 years, Johns Hopkins today tightened its belt.
It's not that the storm has passed us by. It certainly hasn't.
The steps taken affect the teaching and research side of Hopkins, 25,000 employees. Effective immediately, the university is imposing a hiring freeze. It's eliminating overtime. Starting July 1st, a 5% voluntary pay cut goes into effect for top-level staff, about 20 people, including the president and the university's deans. Also starting July 1st, there will be no salary increases for everyone else, except those called for by a labor contract. Layoffs are not included in the budget measures.
We're doing what we're doing the way we're doing it, so that we can do our best to preserve jobs.
In his message to employees today, the university's president noted another impact of the economic slowdown, insurance payments for medical care. That's affecting the healthcare industry statewide. According to the Maryland Hospital Association, in November, hospitals provided more than $83 million in uncompensated care, a 3.5% increase from the $81 million in such care provided in November of 2007. The industry expects the uncompensated care number to grow as people who lose jobs lose their insurance as well.
A key factor that forced Hopkins' hand, the hit its endowment fund has taken, its value is down 20%. Hopkins is hopeful the economic stimulus plan will create new opportunity in research dollars. Reporting live tonight from the newsroom, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.